morning from London. I'm here in the city for the first BTC in town. So excited that I'm gonna do social media for Lanza in this event. And I'm gonna show everything, every detail for you guys. Hope you enjoy. Come on with me.
Oh snap! Oh snap! Oh snap! Oh snap! Oh snap! Oh snap!
I ain't ready for this.
Oh snap!
Oh!
Give me love you long time. All my girls get down on the floor. Back to back, drop it down real low. I'm such a lady, but I'm dancing like a. Cause you know I don't give up, so here we go.
Hi, everyone.
I should be thankful for this woman for putting on all this education. You're gonna see me later, but please. You're just amazing.
Oh, thank you so much. How are you guys? How are you doing? The obligatory two sides, right? Who's from the Netherlands? You go three sides, right? You guys. Hello. Thank you! Hi! I don't know who you are, but hi. So, first of all, I just want to say thank you guys so much. We know that you had a big weekend a couple weekends ago with Salon International and some amazing shows. I was actually at the Trevor show. I don't know if any of you guys were there. And this is what I'm going to say, is the world has changed so much in the last couple of years because of social media. And we're going to talk about that in the trend panel coming up, because we've got a great trend panel for you guys that we're going to get started with. But I want you to just think about this. If you think about the fact that you know everything, well, first of all, you wouldn't be here if you did, but if you think you know everything, or you think that you know the way, I want you to remember Vidal Sassoon. I want you to remember that he was the rebel. Vidal was the one who didn't want to set hair, he wanted to cut hair. Vidal was the one who had an entire walkout where every single person left that salon except one person that we know is Annie Humphries. Vidal was the rebel. Vidal was the rebel. He was the one that nobody believed in and the press talked so badly about. And then he was the father of hairdressing. Please open your minds up today. Be confident with the idea that you can learn. And the one thing that I want to also share with you as well is that what Behind the Chair really believes in is wearable education. Like everything you're going to see today, you're going to be able to take back to the salon tomorrow. There's a place, there's a time for avant-garde and all these amazing hair shows. But what we're doing today is we're blending together what we call collaborations. Collaborations about doing real hair behind the chair every single day. And that's what's made our tours sell out across the US. And this is our first time being in London. Also, these guys are all one shot winners. Put your hands together for Mr. Chris Jones. All the-
I'm honored to be here, guys, in one of the meccas of hairdressing in the world. I can't believe it, on stage with these awesome fellas. I came from Minneapolis, Minnesota, in case you guys don't know where that is. It's smack dab in the middle of the US. It's a great little place. And I'm gonna talk to you guys a little bit about long layers. I know we all here up here work in the salon, right? And so one of the biggest things we hear in the salon is I want something new, I want something fresh, I want something different, but I don't wanna cut any length and I don't wanna cut any layers. This is universal, I believe, correct?
Yes.
Right? Universal. So I'm gonna show you guys what I coined the six-figure haircut. It's a great way to get that Victoria's Secret, beachy wave, long hair. It's a big money maker. The reason I call it the six-figure haircut is because if you can do it well, you will make six figures behind the chair, because we know that 80% of the people have long hair throughout the world.
I need to know this, Matt.
What's that?
I need to know this.
It's on tape.
Can I watch it now?
Yeah, no, just come over, pull up the chair. So, and then you can see in her hair, you can see in Monica's hair, her hair sits a little flat, right? So I'm gonna do some internal layering that's gonna really help girth up those curls, you know? So she's gonna be a little more girthy than she is right now. What's up, Jonesy?
You just broke my train.
Did you just say girth?
Is that not a thing in the UK?
Yeah, no, there's definitely a thing in the UK. Oh, yeah.
I mean, if it's not, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, it's definitely a thing.
I didn't want to offend.
Can I go now?
Oh snap!
So I'm Chris Jones, I'm from Houston.
Oh snap!
Are you ready for this?
Oh snap!
Oh!
Don't be him. you long time. All my girls get down on the floor. Back to back, drop it down real low. I'm such a lady, but I'm dancing like a. Cause you know I don't give up, so here we go.
Opening close of my shear, and I'm gonna work very vertically, right? So my shear matches my subsection. Does that make sense? Around the world, the main trend for hair is that it's healthy, right? It's not short, it's not long, it's not a bob. It's healthy hair is what's the trend. And so we want to be able to maximize the shine with inside, you know, that hair. And then how many of you guys are hairspray addicts out there, right? We eat it for breakfast, use it for deodorant, whatever the case may be. So I love the lustrous finishing spray, you guys, because we talked about this earlier. Two things change the way hair sit: heat and water. What are a lot of hairsprays? Wet, right? So you build this beautiful volume, right? You get these great curls, and then you spray it with hairspray, and it's like watching a balloon fly away at a second grader's birthday, right? You're just like, as the thing just goes, right?
Like watching your favorite pub burn down.
Exactly, that's what I was thinking. Or walking out of a pub and seeing a man laying on the ground.
Yeah, which happens regularly when I come out.
So we go through, we use a little bit of lustrous finishing spray just to finish her off.
From London. I'm here for the first BTC in London. I'm so excited to work at Social... Ah, Kimé.
Fergie and Paula.